I've run 16 marathons, but I've never done an ultra, and it's something I've always wanted to do. I went to the Commonwealth Games here in Melbourne, and I went to the Olympics in Beijing in 2008.
I'm Bree, and I'm a local as well, and not quite as good a runner as Kate here, but I'm more of a recreational runner, run for fun. I've done 5 half marathons, and yeah, I'm excited to do a 50k, which is going to be a huge thing for me to try and achieve.
I've been thinking about doing an ultra for a really long time. I have been procrastinating, and I finally thought, well, I've got no more excuses. I want to tick a few things off my bucket list, and this is definitely one of them.
I did the Surf Eccentric first leg last year, and it was like the time of my life. I absolutely loved it, and I thought if I was ever going to run sort of a longer distance, I wouldn't want to do it on the roads, I want to do it on the trails, and that's why I decided to do this. I just, it was unforgettable, that memory of running next to the cliffs with the sun rising in front of me, and I can't wait to do that again and just do a little bit longer.
I'm feeling a little bit anxious purely because of the expectation I have on myself. But when I drop all of that and I go, I'm actually just doing this for me, it's actually about just really loving running and just not having the pressure of having to compete. Like, just doing it for the pure pleasure of running is what really inspires me and motivates me to actually want to do this run. I have some quirky things that I like to do before my races. Some of them are quite bizarre. And I do like to lie out my clothing the night before and pin my badge. My nameplate, or my racing plate, has to be on the gear in a certain position. And then I do something really random and weird before I start my races. And that's my, I've got this ritual with my husband, and I play the guitar on my abs and he films me. And it's really sad. Race food is something really basic. I'm a celiac, so I just have to have something gluten-free. So I might have a couple of pieces of gluten-free toast, bananas, quinoa porridge, rice porridge. Yeah, nuts and seeds and healthy things on it. And then afterwards, I will tuck into usually a huge piece of gluten-free chocolate cake. Always, actually. And
after I run, generally not as healthy as Kate. I feel like something fatty and salty and milky and like a milkshake and like some chips or something. Because if there's a time where you can eat that, it's probably after you do a run.
Yeah.